Greetings. Some time ago, I created a video and posted it on YouTube. It was titled, A Challenge to Every Muslim on Earth. Here is the link if you want to watch it. Pause the video, write down the URL. Enjoy. Let me briefly recap the challenge. In Surah 61:6, Mohammed claims to recall a statement made by Jesus. As an additional refresher, here is Surah 61:6. And remember, Jesus, the Son of Mary, said, O children of Israel, I am the messenger of Allah, sent to you, confirming the law which came before me, and giving glad tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name shall be Ahmad. Notice, Muhammad says, Jesus said. The challenge is for any Mohammedan on earth to produce book and chapter and verse where Jesus said the things Muhammad claimed Jesus said. Months have gone by and not one Mohammedan has dared to attempt the challenge. And then, just this past week, I received someone's best efforts to defend Muhammad. I'd like to share it with you and dissect it for your benefit, so you can understand the strength of the Islamic argument to defend Muhammad. Here's his message. Part 1. I accepted the challenge in Luke 2:14. You can read this. 14. Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom His favor rests. But if you returned back to the original verse language, I mean Greek or Syriac, the exact translation of the verse to English will be, Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom His favor, Ahmed. Part 2 of his message. Ahmed is an Arabic word derivative from a thankful person. In the Greek language version, the word was barkalitis, and its translation to Arabic is Ahmed. Now, I want an answer from you why your church translated this verse like this. The Arabic translation of Bible used the word Ahmed also. So those were the first two 500-letter messages he posted under the video. Let's look through part 1, line by line, to understand his thinking. Part 1. I accepted the challenge. Simple enough. He has accepted the challenge to produce book and chapter and verse where Jesus said someone named Ahmad would come after him. In Luke 2:14, you can read this. Great! A verse of scripture. Probably book and chapter and verse with Jesus speaking. Quick sanity check. Luke. Yep. One of the Gospels. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom His favor rests. Huh? Glory to God in the highest? I don't really remember Jesus saying these words. And on earth, peace to those on whom His favor rests? What translation is this? Remember the cardinal rule. Never ever believe what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. Well, I looked on Biblos.com, and this is not one of the 19 English translations available there. But I have encountered something like this before with some Arab translations of the Bible that use the word Allah for God and other such confusing compromises. Okay, for the moment, let's imagine this is a valid translation. It is along the same lines as the 19 I found. Who is talking here? Remember the challenge. Book, chapter, and verse where Jesus is talking. Well, the creatures talking here are angels announcing Jesus is born. This verse simply does not apply and cannot ever address the challenge. So problem number one with this is that it is not even Jesus talking. If you are Muslim, I have to ask, do any of you Muslims value intellectual honesty? Are you even trying to get something right and find the truth? But let's keep looking, given the complete illogic of using a verse that does not apply. What else might this Mohammedan try to claim? But if you returned back to the original verse language, I mean Greek or Syriac, the exact translation to the verse to English will be, Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those on whom His favor, Ahmed. Cool. He's using the original language subterfuge. It is generally a lot easier to insert and completely change text if you offer that translators have corrupted it. Remember the cardinal rule. Never ever believe what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. You think I am exaggerating when I say this to you. But let's go look at the original Greek. Here we have the page from biblos.com. You can see this is verse Luke 2:14, the verse he mentions. You can see the English translation, the literal text, glory in the highest to God, and on earth peace among men. And here we see at the end the phrase or word the Mohammedan attempts to change into Ahmed, Eurokias, with whom he is pleased. The Greek word is transliterated Eurokias. For better or worse, Mohammedans are just raised to make stuff up and think you and I are not smart enough to check. Here is my response to this young Mohammedan. Well, that is certainly an interesting diversion from the truth, my friend. The Greek says absolutely nothing about the word Ahmad, and it only makes me wonder if you care about the truth, or just think a lie told in jihad is okay to your Allah. Regardless of the lie, however, the text of Luke 2:14 looks nothing like the claim Muhammad made in Surah 61:6. In fact, Muhammad claimed Jesus said 61:6, while Luke 2:14 is angels speaking, announcing the Son of God. Not shy to defend his position, he replied. The Syrian shepherds that were hearing angels saying this, they weren't speaking Greek, they were speaking Syriac. So by logic, angels weren't saying this song by Greek, they were saying it by Syriac. Or it would be like they were talking to those Syrian shepherds with Japanese, laugh out loud. The word doxa, its translation in Arabic, Hebrew, and Syriac, is praise. A nice attempt at humor to dodge the problem. If I am laughing, perhaps I will not seriously question his claim. But evidently the original language is not Greek, because that fails. So he claims it is Syriac. And I can find no evidence a Hebrew word, doxa, means praise. So to handle this linguistic difficulty, the nationality of the shepherds must be redefined to be Syrians. Can you see how the web of tales and lies just has to grow as each new lie is challenged and thwarted? Wow, no wonder you are confused. The shepherds were Hebrew, not Syrian, and they spoke Hebrew, not Syriac. I just don't know how anybody could be fooled by such ignorance, my friend. And it still does not address the challenge of where Jesus spoke and made the statement Muhammad claimed was spoken in Surah 61:6. You cannot run and hide from the truth, brother. Muhammad's claim was a lie, and no proof exists because his claim was a lie. So what is the basis that the shepherds were Hebrew? Number one, they were near Bethlehem, which is in Judea, not Syria. Number two, Syrians were pagans. And do you think God would send angels to tell pagans his son was born in the city of David? Number three, there is no mention anywhere of any Syrian shepherds coming to the manger. Don't be dismayed by the lies of Islam. Rewriting history is their standard MO. Syrians was speaking Hebrew. Laugh out loud. Are you serious? So he clings to the error that the shepherds were Syrians, receiving the good news of the announcement of the Son of God being born in Bethlehem. This next bit is really choice. The second thing you explained the sentences in the Quran in 61:6 wrong. The Quran didn't say that Jesus say that there is a prophet after me, his name is Ahmed. He continues his message, reciting 61:6 for me. Quran said and mentioned when Jesus the son of Mary said, O children of Israel, indeed I am the messenger of Allah to you, confirming what came before me of the Torah, and bringing good tidings of a messenger to come after me whose name is Ahmad. Remember his dodge. The Quran didn't say that Jesus say that there is a prophet after me, his name is Ahmed. Point one, Jesus talking here, when Jesus the son of Mary said. Point two, Jesus claiming he is a messenger, which means prophet. Indeed, I am the messenger of Allah. Point three, claiming to announce a messenger, meaning prophet, after Jesus, and bringing good tidings or good news or an announcement of a messenger to come after me. Point four, the prophet's name is Ahmad, or spell it Ahmed, it doesn't matter. Spelling does not matter. Whose name is Ahmad? His dodge, the Quran didn't say that Jesus say that there is a prophet after me, his name is Ahmed. I'm sorry, but what kinds of liars are Mohammedans? If you are Muslim, I have to ask, do any of you Muslims value intellectual honesty? Really, what kinds of liars are you people? I have to revise my cardinal rule. Remember the cardinal rule, never ever believe what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. Well, the new cardinal rule has to be, never ever believe anything a Mohammedan says. Period. Evidently you don't read the Quran, my friend. And remember Jesus the son of Mary said, O children of Israel, I am the messenger of Allah, glad tidings of a messenger to come after me whose name shall be Ahmad. The part Mohammed made up saying, and remember Jesus said, means Mohammed claims the words after were words Jesus spoke, or more correctly, words Mo claimed Jesus spoke. Rolling on floor, nice logic. Muslims believe God said those words. You say that Muhammad are the one who said those words. Our prophet Muhammad, well known as a person who can't read or write, so he could never read your holy book. So you have to tell me, how did he copy and paste from your holy book? Jesus in 61:6 didn't say that there is a prophet came after me, his name is Ahmed. But Jesus talked in 61:1, and this is his typo, about signs about a prophet came after him, his name is Ahmed. See the semantic dodge. Allah said, Jesus said, not Muhammad. Then, of course, Mo was unlearned and could not read or write, so he could not copy-paste from the Bible. And Jesus in 61:6 didn't say that there is a prophet came after me, his name is Ahmed. But Jesus talked in 61:6, I've corrected his reference, about signs about a prophet came after me. I just don't know what kind of stupid people listen to lies like this. Remember point three, and bringing good tidings of a messenger to come after me, whose name is Ahmad. Islam is a religion based on lies, and those in Islam will tell lie after lie after lie, as needed to defend and spread their religion. But remember, that does not mean every word from a Mohammedan is a lie. There will be some statements which are coincidentally true. The Bible does have a verse numbered Luke 2:14. The Quran does have a Surah 61:6. The cardinal rule, never ever believe anything a Mohammedan says, period, simply means you must verify, research, critique, treat as suspect any and every claim made in the name of Islam. Be a good Berean. There are no Bereans in Islam. Are you serious, my friend, that now your defense of Muhammad is to claim he could not read, so he had no way to know what Jesus said? Well, praise God, because you have just admitted Muhammad's words are false. he had no basis and no knowledge for even trying to make such a claim that Jesus said anything. Use the mind the real God gave you, brother. Mohammed made this crap up. Jesus never said there would be anyone after him. In fact, Jesus taught he was last. I admit I am not yet perfect in love. Sometimes my human edge just comes through and I say things like crap. In summary, number one, the poster does not even provide a verse with Jesus talking. Number two, the poster tries to change the word of God to inject Ahmad using claims of the Syriac language. Number three, the poster tries this, claiming the shepherds were Syrians, which makes no sense. Number four, the poster then claims the Quran does not say what the Quran says, which is a fascinating deception based on the power of suggestion, reminiscent of stage hypnosis acts. No, the Quran does not say what it says. It says what I tell you it says. Anyway, I hope you find it useful and informative to see the attempts Mohammedans make to excuse and defend their religion. Remember, Islam is a religion based on lies, and those blinded by it will follow their programming. Christians, pray for Muslims, because they are blind in darkness and cannot see. If we say we can see, we must live the life that demonstrates we can see. Christians, hold on to the truth. Be good Bereans. Study to show yourselves approved unto God. And don't worry what men may think. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.